In the fall of 1835, the tension between the Texians and Mexicans was reaching new heights. When Stephen F. Austin put out the call for soldiers in response to the arrival of General Cos and several hundred Mexican soldiers in Texas, Travis was ready to answer. By September 28th, he was enrolled as a lieutenant in what Austin referred to as the Federal Army of Texas. War began in Gonzales on October 1st, when Cos demanded the surrender of the Gonzales Come and Take It cannon. Travis joined the hundreds of Texians who hastened there, but he arrived too late to see action. Military forces were organized more formally after the battle at Gonzales, and on the 19th of October, Travis joined up with Austin and his forces. Austin's army moved to within 5 miles of San Antonio, where Cos's command was stationed to besiege the town. On October 27th, Austin ordered Travis to raise a volunteer company of cavalry of his own to serve as a scouting and reconnaissance unit, and Travis was soon promoted to captain. Austin had great confidence in Travis, assigning him further missions and commending his service in several letters. Travis did not remain at San Antonio through the final assault in early December, but returned to San Felipe. He advised on the organization of cavalry for the army, but turned down a commission as a major of artillery. And on December 21st, Travis accepted a commission as a lieutenant colonel of cavalry and became the chief recruiting officer for the army. It was an impressive rise in rank that Travis achieved in less than 3 months.